So in our current lesson, we start to meet our project and we start to add some content like a title tag and a header. And we can see that we write some simple instructions using PUG, like just the name of the tag and the content and some indentation. And all of that gets converted each time we save the file into HTML. Once it gets converted into HTML, the browser can pick up those changes and display them inside it. Okay, so let's fix this issue where our local server wants to present something but cannot. So let's open the src folder, and inside it we can see this readme file, and let's right click and open preview and start reading a bit the contents of it. And at some point we get to the place where it suggests we should create an index.pug file in this folder to start. So let's create a new file, index. Well, again, create, right-click, new file, index.pug. And once I create that index.pug file, we can see that a TMP folder has been created, and inside it, there is an index.html file. Let's open this one as well. And then I want you to find this, let's say, split window button, and then click on it. And once you clicked on that, I want you to close the file that is next to the index.html file that is next to index.pug file, because I want to have PUG here and then index.html here. Okay, so let's close that file, and then you can press Alt Shift 0 to toggle the split horizontally or vertically. And it's easier for us to see if we toggle them horizontally, right? So let's type something into the index.pug, like doc type HTML without that, HTML. And when we save it, we can hear a sound that PUG has converted this content into HTML. Doesn't look like much right now, but let's continue and type some more. Let's create an HTML tag. And when we save it, we can see that PUG has created for us an HTML tag with an opening and a closing. Okay? So now let's do some more. Let's type here head and then body and save it. Well, we can see that head and body have been created for us into the index.html. However, it's not exactly what we want. If you're familiar with HTML, we want the head and the body to be inside HTML, not next to it. So in order to do that in PUG, we want to indent them as long as some content, some tags are indented in relation to the one on top, then those tags become children of that one. So now head and body, as soon as we save, should become children of HTML, which means it will place them inside. So let's save. And now you can see that by indenting tags, those ones become children of the parent that they have been indented in relation to. So let's continue some more. For example, if we type a title here, we can see the title is at the same level as head and body because it's exactly at the same level as HTML title and body over here. Now we want the title to be inside head, so let's hit tab once or space space. It's exactly the same thing. So let's save it, and now we can see that the title tag has been generated inside the head. Okay, now let's add some content. In order to add some content into PUG, we want to type space after the tag and then add some content to that tag. Okay, now you can see that add some content to that tag has been added and generated inside that title tag. On top of that, I want you to type some content of yours. So if you type add some content to that tag, it's okay, but not good. It's not gonna teach you how it's not gonna help you become confident. So I want you to type any other content other than add some content to that tag, anything else. The weather is beautiful. Pick some content, make it your own, save that out of your hands, some HTML has been generated, and you'll become, or at least you'll get more confident about those processes. Okay, now let's not type H1 here, let's just type H1 as a child of the body, so we know that we want to add some indentation, and H1 stands for header 1, or, well, the main header, and then in order to add some content, we know that we want to add a space, and type something like the weather is ultra, mega, fine. Again, you don't want to type the weather is ultra, mega, fine, you want to type anything else but that. Right, you want to type something of your own. So you can see that we've typed some PUG over here, and all we've done is to type the tags and the content of it without the lesser sign, without the greater sign, without the slash, this greater sign, without having to worry about the opening and the closing. The opening and the closing. We did not have to worry about any of that. All we had to worry is to respect some indentation, type the name of the tag and the content of the tag, and PUG has generated HTML for us in a nice way. And this is just the start of it. PUG can help us with a lot more than just this. Now, what we've done so far is we've at least understood that files that I've prepared for you in order to create this project, well, you type npm start and somehow it starts a process that watches for file changes. As soon as we press save, it takes whatever it's inside here, just a second, it takes whatever it's inside index.pug, which is this content, then it converts it into HTML, which is this index.html. So that index.pug gets converted to that, or this content over here gets converted to this content. And then it gets sent to our browser. And if we switch to our browser and refresh, we can see that the weather is ultra mega fine, and the title is add some content to that tag. Now let's find more a bit about PUG and then start solving our project. So in the next lesson, we get to meet our PUG starter that has bootstrapped our project MyCV version 2 Junior, and you can see that different devices across different browsers are synchronized, and we are developing and testing across multiple ones.